Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question that was asked by Rupel in one of my Excel seminars. This is a question that drove me crazy in the seminar because I knew there was some way to solve the problem, but I couldn't remember the obscure function. And this is also a netcast where I bet that I'll get email from several people saying, hey, Bill, there's a better way to do that. Feel free to drop me an email. The question that Rupel had was she had a worksheet with all the months going across the worksheet tabs, and she'd love to have a way, a function, in cell A1 that would return the name of the tab. So that way if she's named the tabs, the months, January, Feb, or April, May, June, basically that function will pull the name of the tab and she won't have to change the worksheets all the time to re-enter the information. Now I knew that there was a way to do this. I couldn't remember it on the spot. Turns out that there is an old Lotus 123 function called cell. And the cell function, you can basically ask for any one of 10 different types of information about any particular cell. Now we don't care what cell it is, so in this case I'm just going to use cell A1, but what I'm going to ask for is the file name. And the strange thing about the file name is that it returns us the complete path to the file, the name of the file, in square brackets. I have no idea why they use square brackets, and then after that, the name of the worksheet. So this kind of gets us close. Now to actually solve the problem, we need to isolate just the name of the worksheet. My example back here in February, my first stab at this was, if all of your worksheet names happen to be exactly 3 characters long, we could just ask for the rightmost 3 characters using the right function. So equal right cell file name A1 and then ask for 3 characters, and that'll work fine. Now that's kind of cheating and it assumes that all of your worksheets have the same name. What if someone comes along and renames Jan to January? Now this is much harder to solve, unfortunately. My first step was I said, okay, let's find that right square bracket. So use the find function to find the right square bracket and find out that that is at position 64. Next thing I did was use the length function, L-E-N, to find out how long the entire path file name and worksheet name is. In this case, it's 71. I then jammed all of those together into one big, huge formula that basically says we're going to take the rightmost characters from the function and then uses the length function and the find function to put all that together into one big string. Now the great thing about this is that cell A1 is a formula. If I type anything, it will automatically update with the information. Now once we've entered that formula in one sheet, there's a great trick to enter the formula in all of the sheets. I have January selected. I'm going to shift click on the last worksheet. That puts me in group mode. I'll edit cell A1 and then hit enter, and sure enough we should see that all of the worksheets now have that formula showing us the worksheet name. That was a great question from Rupel. Using the old cell function from Lotus 123 is one way to solve this. I know that you could use VBA, a quick VBA function. If you have any better way of solving this problem, please drop me a note at bill@MrExcel.com and we'll show it on a future podcast. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.